So y'all want me kind of angled like this or straight ahead or?
As natural as possible to go.
So you've described yourself as an evangelical Christian. You did a campaign ad where you said the most important lessons in life are in this book right here, meaning the Bible. Everyone in politics likes to brag that they're a person of faith. Why is faith good?
Faith has a way of softening people. For example, if you look at the teachings of Jesus, he's very forgiving.
He also said, if a man doesn't abide in me, he is cast forth as a branch and withers, and the branches are gathered, thrown into the fire, and burned.
Right.
Well, so, well,
I do think, because I'm a Christian, that Jesus is the way to be reconciled. And I do believe the actual literacy of that story. We'll let God sort out all the details of that at Judgment Day.
But what about the Ten Commandments? I mean, so many politicians talk about the Ten Commandments. Are they really the ten most
suggestions?
Important
are these,
moral
the ten suggestions? The ten recommendations?
But it's not really a wise list of ten. You know, the first four are all about just worshiping God and basically that he's a jealous God and he doesn't want you to have any other gods. The only two that are really laws are don't steal and don't kill. Why is this the wisest group of ten? It doesn't include child abuse. It doesn't include don't torture. It doesn't include a lot of things, rape, that I think if we were making a list today, we would probably include.
Society is so different today, and our culture is so radically
and
different.
And that's what
today.
I'm asking. Yeah. We're in a different culture. Can you think of anything else that we still cleave to from the Bronze Age?
Well, basically, murder is against the law in every country in the world.
But wouldn't we have come to that even without religion?
I mean,
don't you think people would have gotten together and said, you know what, let's not slaughter each other and let's not take each other's stuff?
I don't know.
There's been more killing in the name of my God.
You think maybe sort of indigenously or just by our DNA, we somehow know that killing another person is wrong. I'm not sure that that's the case.
Really? You need God to decide not to kill each other?
You can look back at more primitive cultures, and they were constantly at war.
We are now among industrialized modern nations the most religious nation. A recent study found that among 32 countries, more people in this country doubted evolution than any other country on that list, except I think it was Turkey.
In the U.S., we have freedom of religion.
I think most of the countries on that list do have freedom of religion.
Well, it's interesting.
Do you believe in evolution?
You know, I don't know. Clearly, the scientific community is a little divided on some of the specifics of that, and I understand that.
I don't think they are.
No,
I think they pretty much agree.
I don't know how it all happened. I mean, I'm certainly willing to.
But it couldn't possibly have been Adam and Eve 5,000 years ago with a talking snake in a garden, could it?
Well, it could have possibly been that.
Come on. This is my problem.
Yeah.
Is I'm trying. I mean, you're a senator. You are one of the very few people who are really running this country. It worries me that people are running my country who believe in a talking snake.
You don't have to pass an IQ test to be in the Senate, though.